Welcome back, third period action from Marlboro. The Jeff Parody Tournament. 7-1 Flames lead over the Boston Junior Huskies. They've won all three of their games this weekend and look to be well on their way here with a 6-goal lead, capped off with Elliot Grunwald's goal with 7.6 left in the second. Flames will be coming our way for this period again. That's Hemenway trying to get on that puck, fired it up there, just off the stick of the intended target. That was Kylie. Dipped into the zone by the Huskies. They seem to have a little bit more life in the second period. They allowed 3 goals instead of 4. Let's just put it that way. That's about how much more life they have. This puck comes for Murphy. Played right in front. He was looking for Kylie, who was open back door. Still loose there in the slot. No one could get a real good shot off as Hemenway came in. Trying to launch one on goal. Did not go. Played up the wall. Pinching in there is Smethurst. He'll keep it in. Deflected right through the blue paint and out the other side into the corner. Hemenway crunches his man along the wall. Cox. You got obstructed there for the referee for a second. Sorry. Come free for Cox. Shot flunkered down by the goaltender. He makes a save. Faceoff coming here on the right side. Right, the right side for us. Left side if you're the Flames. Into the corner, this is Dermody. Trying to come free with a little bit of move there. Couldn't pull it off. Instead, he's forced to take the battle to the corner. That's Dermody. Young played up the wall to the line. Pelletier holding on to it. Back into the corner for Dermody. That got telegraphed as it hit the goal line. Played to the line. That puck did come out off Pelletier, so he's forced to kind of regather it. Dermody was not quick enough coming out of the zone, though. Thus, and offside. So 2 minutes into this third period. So I went over it in the first period, but it might as well again. The purpose of the parody tournament is to kind of serve as a measuring stick to place these teams in the correct divisions against the correct opponents for next year. All the teams are playing. They want to be in the top division, the black division. And if you win your little bracket here in this tournament, you're a lock for that division. And seems like it's safe to say with the 3 games, 3 wins prior for the Flames, and the potential, air quotes there, potential win today over the Huskies, they would be a lock for that division next year. Just onside is Dermody as he makes his entry. Goes hard into the wall. Maurice picking it up. This is Maurice. Sharp angle shot. Knocked down. He had that sharp angle laser beam goal in the second. Might have been the 5th goal. Into the slot again. Off the crossbar from Maurice. Young was fishing in front for the rebound. It was so hard it blasted by him there. Puck comes back and Murphy's forced to regroup. He goes down there on the half wall, but got it up to center. This is Folsom coming in, having some trouble there. Goes into the corner now. Fysek lurking on the outside there. This is Folsom cutting right into the goal. He got a good shot off before he got knocked down. It went off the outside of the net. Now it's Fysek. He goes down as the Huskies come out. Crosses the blue line in the offensive zone. Long shot, batted away. Back is Murphy now. Seems like he's been moved back to defense. Here in lieu of the score and the time left in this hockey game. Young's up on forward in his place, I believe. The neutral territory, the Huskies will re-corral this, bounced off the wall. Fysek trying to pick it up. He does. Got it to the red line, not much further. Banked in quickly back out though. Offside now called against the Flames. Ten thirty left to go in period three. Flames. Flames will come in. Centered back in front on the top of the crease. Score! Knocked in by Cox. Hemingway was there too. Right under the goaltender's pad, 8-1. I think it's safe to call it there at 8-1. At the Flames will be in the top tournament or top division after they're averaging, I think, so they've scored 6 goals in 2 games and 8 goals in 2 games. It's averaging about 7 goals a game. My. Certainly not a lack of that. Clean draw in by Hemingway. Bombed right in there. Rebound was loose only for a second as it's covered up. 2 Flames were in there. Grunwald let one fly. Didn't look like he got all of it. Kind of a knuckle puck twisting up in the air there. So we'll do it again. Hemingway digs in. Won another draw, but this time the Flames couldn't gain possession and the Huskies will tip it back into the offensive zone for them. Grunwald comes across picking up that puck. Grunwald, he's got 2 tonight. Grunwald coming in, straight to the goal, and blocked off by the goaltender as Cox and Grunwald were stuffing away for the rebound. Huskies folks aren't happy that the that was a great stop with the goaltender off a rushing Grunwald, but Husky folks aren't happy that the Flames keep going to the net so hard. And the referee kind of said something to Cox about not charging the net as hard, stuffing away maybe in an 8-1 game. But he goes, that puck was loose, ref. You can see it right in front here because we were right behind the goal. Well, it's interesting. You know, to debate whether they should be going to the net as hard in an 8-1 game. Offside called the line against the Flames. You could say probably, well, that puck's loose. They have all the right to go get for it. Doesn't matter the score. Or you could say, well, it's a 1 game, you know, you could let up a little bit. Depends on what side you're on. As Germany marches right in there. Great stop, rebound. Another great stop. He got that one with the glove off Young. The rebound was the more impressive of the two. Although Dermody, the stop on Dermody was pretty good as well. He has been pretty good, the goaltender for the Huskies. It's tough, though, to get worn down when you see so many shots. He's seen a lot tonight, a lot of chances from the Flames. Scoreboard shows just that, too. This is Young. Trying to move it over to the middle for Maurice. Just was behind him. Flames come into the zone only for a second. Taken right back out. Murphy taking it off the wall there. Spinning, trying to find some open space. Fired it up there for Young. Doesn't go. Said the Huskies come in 8-12. Left on the clock here in the third. Murphy will pick up the puck, and the defenseman now playing defense will move in on the left side, center in front, save made off Baker's shot, and a little bit of extra stick action there between Young and a Husky player as Young was going to the net. On the right side, Ryan Lucchigo. Folsom. Puck comes back. Shot deflected and wide. Falling down there in center was Riccio. And he did a little spinorama before falling. He's on the puck now in the corner. Riccio on around. Smethurst had a touch there. Comes back to the other corner for Riccio. Riccio for Smethurst. Up the wing for Folsom. Folsom, he's got a man ahead at center. That is Baker. Folsom taking his dandy time crossing the blue line. Dipsy doodling right in there. Lost the puck and now it's in front, top of the crease. No shot came from either Folsom or Baker or the other Flames players. Now puck will come out in the offensive zone for the Huskies. Quickly back. Folsom trying to tip it by the defenseman, does not go. Played on a cross. Hemingway ends up on his backside. Puck into the corner here. Swung on goal, never made it. Cleared there by the Flames. It looks like Baker's ahead of the play. He was way ahead. I'll never understand that. He was way ahead of him at the dot, and they still called icing. I don't understand that. I suppose because it's 8-1, you know, exceptions, this, that, the other thing, but... Yeah, I don't know. Faceoff comes to the left of Tristan Kerr. Draw one by the Flames. Cox couldn't get it to center. Into the zone, long shot launched on net. Easily stick to side and into the corner by Kerr. Hemingway on behind, that's Cox. They battle away up just above those hash mark half wall area. Into the corner it goes now. Grunwald. Grunwald for Kylie it was. He couldn't get a good handle on it. Flames are looking a little tired right now. There goes the camera again. Apologize. The ceiling's not as pretty as the hockey game to look at. Not as fun or as entertaining as the hockey game to look at. Although, it's an 8-1 hockey game, so it's not the most entertaining thing in the world either. Only 5:30 left in this one, though. Flames are looking a little bit tired. Both these teams are. They're playing 4 games this weekend. And this will be it for the teams for the summer. For the Flames, they'll start skating in August. Yes, they'll start skating at the end of August. And then they'll meet back up again and the hockey season will be in. Meanwhile, it's Dermody straight to the net, he scores! Dermody gives the goaltender the splits, tucks it away, and this one's in the back pocket of the Flames now. It's 9-1. If it wasn't in the back pocket before, it certainly is now. Huskies persisting on behind the net. Murphy knocked that puck free in the corner. He'll try to come up the wall with it, chipped it to himself. Trying to leave Baker outside of the zone. Does not go. On behind the goal now, Fysak. Fysak, bad bounce off the wall. Allows the Huskies to keep it in. Folsom cannot get that puck out. It's been mostly in the Flames end here, actually, for this third period, though. It's mostly just a squabble of pucks. Here's a race for it. Baker tracking ahead. He goes on behind. Baker right out in front. Almost tucked that one in. That would have been pretty, boy, wouldn't it have been? As I was saying, though, puck's mostly been in the Flames' end this period, but kind of just chipping it around. Nothing really coming of anything that the Huskies are doing. But phone time. We have zone time now. Folsom had that puck, and he'll clear it. Folsom, he's got Baker ahead of him on side play. Folsom going right through. Folsom, no. Brian Folsom trying to charge the cage. Doesn't go. Now Pelletier to the line. Everything is a mass of stripes there. That's the one thing about putting yourself behind the goal. You'll get a nice picture of Mike and White Stripes there for a little bit, blocking the view. Nothing you can really do about that. As long as they're officiating correctly, they can have my spot. Maurice got into one high. Oh, sorry, that was not Maurice, that was Riccio. My bad. Still a heck of a shot. Out to center comes Riccio. He'll play it off the wall. 2:25 left in this one, and I think we know the end result. Cox, we've known the end result for a while now. Cox still battling away at his own blue line, knocked it free. Hemenway will move up. He'll make it inside the zone. Hemenway with a shot just wide of the glove side of the Husky goaltender. Jarring that puck is Cox. Jarred it free. Couldn't hold on to it. Got it back, though. Cox for Fysek playing defense. Usually at under center. He's been under center for most of this game. They must have made some changes. Moving players around here. Because of the score. This is Fysek. Moving right in. Fysek, a nice move. Dragged down. Comfrey for Hemenway with a shot right along the ground. Save was made, and then again, Kylie goes to the goal. He didn't even really go in hard. The Huskies make sure to clear him of the crease. Coming back, comes back to the line. Thrown right into the slot there with a squabble for a second. 1:10. 66 seconds left to go. Shot score. Grunwald. That was just a laser of the shot. And now it's just salt on the wound. 10-1. Grunwald snipes one home. Goodness. 8 was their cap against the Monarchs. They've now exceeded that by 2 goals. Seconds. Huskies are on the half wall now. Most of the eyes here are on the clock. Admittedly, just, you know, looking around. Half a minute left to play as it's down in the corner now for Murphy. This is Leo Murphy swirling up the right side and out to Grunwald, persisting on that puck. He got it. Young goes to the goal, trying to get it to him. He did. On behind. 15 seconds to go. This is Young. Shoots a punch to the side of the head of a player, and then Grunwald checks him right into the wall. Oof, yikes. 2 and then 1. This game was over a while ago, but now it is over for certain. 10-1, your final score. Manchester Flames are locked in the Black Division for the 2017-18 hockey season. With 4 straight victories here today in the parity tournament, I suppose we'll see you next year. Final score, 10-1, Flames over the Junior Huskies. Have a nice day, folks.